Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding every election is presidential written by Sanjay Baru. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science and public administration optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the division of the voters. This editorial is about how the voters, they vote for the political parties. This editorial is also about how in essence the Indian electorate system, Indian election system and Indian voting system is following the tenets of the presidential system. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to dichotomize between what is meant by a core voter and what is meant by a non-core voter. Now as far as the core voter is concerned, core voter is one that sticks to a particular party. Core voter is one that has been influenced by the tradition of that party, and because the tradition is guiding the voter to vote for a political party. Now core voter is one which will really look into what the party is offering it now. Its main attachment, its main love is for the party's ideology, the solid ideology on which it was founded. So anybody who forms a part of the core voter for the Congress believes in the good days that were provided by Jawaharlal Nehru, that was provided by Lal Bahadur Shastri, or that was provided by Rajiv Gandhi. I'm not talking about Indira Gandhi phase. Now any core voter who votes for Bharatiya Janata Party believes in their core ideology of Hindi, Hindu and Hindutva. So on the other hand, we have the non-core voters. We have the voters which swings like pendulum. Now these voters, they play a deciding role in deciding about who is going to win the elections. Now this swinging voter, this deciding voter, it is not glued to the tradition of a political party. It is not attached to a political party. Now the swinging voter is more into a kind of thing by which it is influenced. And what is that thing? The thing is the personality. The thing is the ingenuity exhibited by a particular leader of a particular party. Now this swinging voter is influenced, is mesmerized by the way the lectures by the leaders are delivered, by their oratory skills, by the way they have promised to transform India. Now, when we look at this entire system of the core and the non-core voters, when India got its independence, the share of the core voters were more. And the share of the non-core voters was quite less. But of late, what we are seeing is the withering, is the erosion of this core basis. And there has been a rise of this non-core voters. And it is the non-core voters that basically decide. Now the non-core voter is decided by the liberalistic values. Non-core voter will vote for you only if you will put forward a development agenda. Non-core voter will vote for you only if you will show him the big dreams. Non-core voter will vote for you if you will be secular. Because this non-core voter is not a young voter, it is not an old voter. It is not something who believes in tradition. So the decisive factor in the Indian election system is this non-core voter. This is a new class that has emerged. And because of this new class, what we are witnessing is the change, the transformation on the planks of which the elections are fought in India. In theory, we are a parliamentary form of government. We form governments on the basis of the majority of a political party. But in reality, the votes are garnered, the votes are magnetized by the personalities, by the leaders, and by their charisma, by their aura. Now, since independence, another big change that we have seen is the development of the state-wise leaders. In the beginning, what we were having was just an all India level leaders, like Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel we had. We had Jawaharlal Nehru at that point of time. We also had Mahatma Gandhi. We have Siraj Gopalacharya. Now, these were the leaders of very high stature, but these leaders were at a national level. There was non-existent of the state level leaders. In the beginning, there was over-enthusiasm about nationalism. You can also call it that was a phase of pseudo-chauvinism. Something more than nationalism, but less than chauvinism, is the pseudo-chauvinism. Now, what we are witnessing, or what phase we are currently living in, the nationalism has subsided. Now, what has grown is the regionalism. What has grown is the caste-based politics. What has grown is the issue-based politics. Now, issue-based, the caste-based, and the region-based politics, it has given rise to the local leaders. Now, these local leaders, the charisma, the personality, and their ingenuity is what is magnetizing the voters. The swinging voters, they don't vote for the ideology of the party. They vote for the promise of transformation and for the change that they have promised the people to promote. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-000 in case you're interested in buying the video class in IAS Civil Services Preparation. And to view the information of the classes that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And do participate in the answer writing program. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.